Hello friends, today we do this exercise how to plot the pole of a given plane. So let's take some examples like 110, 30 degree, 200. So we can write this 200 as southwest, this is dip direction, this one is dip amount and this one is strike. So let's plot this plane on the stereographic projections. This is dip direction is 200. So let's count on the periphery of the stereo net 110, 190, 200. So actually this is dip direction, so as we have discussed in our previous videos, we have to rotate this dip direction towards the equator. So this is west direction, is the nearest point of the equator. 30 degree is the dip amount, so we have to count 30 degree on the equator, 10, 20 and 30. This is point. So let's match or draw this great circle along this point. This is north and this is south. So this is our plane. So pole is always perpendicular to the plane. This is dipping direction towards southwest direction. So pole is always perpendicular to the plane. So what we have to do, we have to bring this transparency towards the north and south direction like this. This is strike. So what we have to do, we have to count from this point 90 degree in the opposite direction of the dipping direction. So this is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. So this is the pole of this plane. So let's bring this transparency its original position. So now we can see, if we plot a plane, pole is always perpendicular and opposite to the given quadrant. So this is the dip direction in the southwest quadrant and pole is always towards the northeast quadrant. For example, in the second case, this is our second example, 250 degree, 290 degree. So if we want to plot this plane here, 290 degree, this is dip direction. So this is 280, 290 degree. So bring this point towards the equator. This is then dip amount is 50 degree. So 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So this is, if we draw this great circle, this will be the plane of this data. So we can directly plot the pole from this point, counting 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. So this is our second data. Now comes to the third one. Now we can see the dipping direction is northwest direction in the northwest coordinate. So the pole is always perpendicular or diagonally in the opposite quadrant, in the southeast quadrant. Now take another example. This one is 180, 90 and 90 degree towards the eastern side. So let's take 90 degree. This is 90 degree. So this is already on the equator, so we don't need to rotate the transparency. So count the 90 degrees. So 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. So this is the 90 degree in the center of the stereographic projection. So the pole of this plane should be at the periphery. Maybe this direction or maybe this direction. But here we have mentioned towards the eastern direction because this is the vertical plane. So it may be dip towards the east and it may be dip towards the west. Actually this is a vertical. So there is no significance towards the east and towards the west. The pole may be towards this direction and may be towards this direction. So this pole is on the periphery. The periphery pole always indicate that the plane should be vertical like this. Let's take another example. We have another example. The strike is 070 degree. Dip amount is 0 degree and dipping towards southeast coordinate, or we can say 160 degree. So let's count 160 degree. 90, 100, 110, 120, 130, 140, 50 and 60. So 160, this is the dip direction. So we have, what we have to do, we have to bring this towards the equator. So this is the equator nearest point. This is, and the dip amount is 0 degree. So 0 degree is at the periphery. So this will be the great circle. If I draw the great circle from north to south, this will be the great circle. So the pole should be at the center. So this is our pole of this plane. So we can mark it like this. This is the fourth plane. Now this is how to plot the plane of the Now we have some another exercise related to this this pole plotting. Now we can see, let's take an example. The examiner can ask such type of question, in different examination like this, related to fold. If suppose that we have an upright fold and examiner give the pole of the upright fold. What is upright fold? Upright fold is that fold in which the axial plane is at 90 degree. If suppose that we want to plot the pole of this upright fold, the pole should be at the periphery. Because this is 90 degree, 90 degree means the plane should be vertical. So the pole should be at the periphery. And it may be anywhere on the periphery. It may be here. It may be here. So based on the pole we can tell this is the upright fold. Oops. Then some in second example, suppose that examiner give the pole of the recumbent fold. As we know, what is recumbent fold is the fold in which axial plane dips at 0 to 10 degree. That means approximately horizontal. So horizontal pole, the pole of the horizontal plane should be at the center. So we can tell based on this pole presentation, this is the recumbent fold. So in any exam, examiner can ask based on the pole plotting, if suppose that he give you the pole at the center and he can ask what is the type of the fold. So we can tell this one is the recumbent fold. But we have to read the question very carefully. If the pole of the axial plane is mentioned in the question, then we can interpret it very easily. Then third one, inclined fold. As we know, name is indicate. Inclined fold means the axial plane of the fold dip between 80 degree to 10 degree. As we know, 0 to 10 degree recumbent and 90 degree, 80 to 90 degree upright fold. So inclined fold varies 80 to 10 degree. The pole, those are laying in between from center to periphery. Please be careful, I am talking about the poles, not the plane. So in between center to the periphery, that is the inclined fold. Similarly, based on this data, we can interpret about the fold also. As we know, high angle fold, more than 45 degree. If suppose that we have pole like this, in between, rather than center and to the periphery, that is high angle fold. And if the low angle fold means less than 45 degree, so approximately we can tell in the examination this one is low angle fold. Thank you very much. I hope you have enjoyed this video a lot. Thank you very much.